guys are all nuts.
No sneakers. Wow.
Do you like the sneakers? All right.
Whoa!
And I have to tell you, I bought those here yesterday. So they're my Florida sneakers. I shall ever think of you whenever I wear them.
That's great.
And are you having a birthday today?
It's not today, it's this year, and I'll be 90, and that's why I
awesome.
May.
Awesome. I love the hat. Who gifted you the hat?
Tammy did.
Who's Tammy? Well done. Well, give her a round of applause. I want one when I get 90, or maybe next year. I'm having a little problem with it, it's a little limp here. Anybody have any Viagra? And I'm not touching it. Okay. Oh, I put a Facebook picture of my sneakers. I had two selections. One was white with green soles, and the other were these. And I put them on my Facebook page, and I said, "What do you think?" I got more than 350 people commenting on which ones I should buy, and it was overwhelmingly the clown shoes. So I thought, you know, I had the girl really going to invite you to be a part of my newsletter group, which is administered through Yahoo, and it's free and worth every penny. Double your money back if you're not delighted. How many people already get my monthly newsletter? Oh, you came anyway. Thank you. I write about what amuses me, and sometimes I have no time, so I have the dog write it. It's about what I think sometimes, and other times it's things that happen. I remember writing about toilets that flush themselves. Don't like them. But the way around that is to carry a post-it note. And then you cover the electric eye with a post-it note, and then it doesn't see when you're done, which is okay by me, because I don't think any toilet needs to know exactly when I'm done. I would tell it. Rip off the post-it note, and then it flushes at will. If you don't have a post-it note, and a lot of people don't travel with post-it notes, chewing gum works well too. You want to remove it before the next person comes in. If you have very long arms, you can also use your thumb. But it's a lot harder. Psychic lawnmower repair, because my husband got an extended warranty program and it was going to be up, and so we were trying to guess what things would break between the time it was now and the time, well, then there was a time I thought his dental work was pulling in a radio station. I was really excited because I thought we would save a lot on batteries and I could just figure out how to tune him so that I could get the state. It didn't turn out to be that at all. But anyways, now, if at some point you can't hear me because my mouth isn't in the right place, if you would take your right hand and wave it around like this, practice, go ahead. That way I know I should speak louder or orient my face to the microphone. If, on the other hand, you have a question, that's your left hand. Try that. If I don't hear your question, I just go like that.
Thank you. This is another Twisted Sisters. This one is called Truly Twisted because I accidentally made a block with the template backwards. And then I thought, well, if one is a mistake, then half of them is a design element. So then I made half of them the wrong way and half of them the right way. Now, you really need to make sure that when you make quilts, that you add sleeves. So seriously, if you want to put your quilt on exhibit, they require sleeves. It's best if you take the sleeves from your husband's shirts. First of all, he has longer arms than you do, and second of all, if you put it back in the closet, he's never going to notice.
But wait, it gets better. Are you ready?
Does your dog like it?
My dog?
Yeah.
No.
Baby.
No, they're married now, you know. And
no.
Anyway, this is a puzzle ball. Oh. It comes apart. So after you have an infant who chews and sucks on it, then you teach the older kid, how in the world does this come together and come apart again? Isn't that fun? This is the size medium. There's a smaller one, then there's a medium, then there's a large, and then there's a Shamu. It's about the size of a basketball.
Do you have the pattern?
No! I'm writing it. First, I'm doing more research. I need to know what kind of fabric is best, and I'm trying to figure out the best way to sew it. So I figured out the sewing part. I'm experimenting with the fabric. This is made with crushed velvet, and this is minky.
Yeah.
That's very nice. The easiest one to sew, believe it or not, is flannel. You hardly have to pin it. Flannel works beautifully. I've done the minky. I've tried Tyvek because I wanted to make one for the dog. Not satisfying at all. No. No. Just if you really like the dog, you'll just hand stitch one for me. Also, I discovered that you don't have to hand sew them. You could. Now I'm nervous if I can get it back or not. That's not it. Takes a minute. You got it. Fiddling around. There we go. Whew. Thank you. But that's a huh? Oh, good job.
Get our hand back in the ruler snappy. We'll just do that.
Right now you're on.